So welcome to our job. You know, we talk about this all the time. We feel like we have the coolest job in the world. And it's funny because you're like tonight, you get to meet a lot of people backstage. When you're a comedian, the number one thing people say to you when they meet you, they're like, where do you come up with material? And the honest answer, I think, at least for us, is the best stuff is not stuff you make up. It's true stuff. Now, that being said, I have to share this story with you. Last year, I was hosting a show for the Children's Hospital in Atlanta, and a couple came up to me, and the man said to me, hey, I bet you done heard of a redneck thing. And I was thinking, well, I've heard a lot of them, but I love talking to folks. I said, no, go ahead. He said, my wife and I decided if we ever had the chance to meet you that we had to tell you about the time we were down at her family's house, and while we were there, her brother got his nipple bitten off by a beaver. I said, you have my attention. Because it's kind of hard to walk away from a story like that. You're almost required to say, how did that happen? Oh, and they were happy to share the whole tale. Apparently, the brother and his buddy were driving down the road, and a beaver ran across the street, and they accidentally hit it with a truck, and then the beaver went down into the ditch on the side of the road. So they decided they were going down in the ditch to find this thing because they wanted to take it to the taxidermist, because we all know how pretty they look on a Thanksgiving dining room table just holding that turkey up. So he said he went down in the ditch, he found the beaver, he picked it up by the tail, and he said, look at it. It ain't cut up or bloody or nothing. And apparently, nothing is the word that brings a beaver back to consciousness. And at that point, the animal lurched out and bit his nipple off. Did not bite it, bit it off. O-F-F off, bit it off. That is a new kind of hurt right there. And it is so rare, I am at a loss for words. The only reply I could come up with, I said, I bet that is the only time in history the headline of the paper could include the words beaver and nipple and nobody be offended by it.